Hey, what's up, fellas? How you doing? Matt Antonelli here.
Hey, what's going on, guys? How you doing? Matt Antonelli here. Today we're looking at arm actions depending on the position. So we're going to look at the shortstop position, and then we're going to look at the outfield position. For shortstop, you can really just think about any infielder. Now, depending on the position, your arm action is going to change. So if you go from longest arm action to shortest arm action, typically the outfielders are going to have the longest arm action because they have to throw the ball the longest distance, right? And pitchers as well, because they're trying to throw as hard as possible. Then it goes to infielders. They're going to have a little bit of a shorter arm action. And then finally, you're going to see the catcher's arm action is the absolute shortest because they need to get the ball out as quickly as possible, and they're not throwing the ball very far. So let's look at some of the things that are unique between the infielders and the outfielders. So, and we'll also look at the similarities. So let's just start with the very first thing. The first thing is, no matter the position, the ball always comes to the middle of the body, somewhere right around the chest area. So you can see both players, we have Willie Adames over here, we have Cody Bellinger over here. Both players are going to get the ball, they're going to bring the ball to the middle of their body. All right, so that's the first thing. And again, this happens for every position. A pitcher is going to come set somewhere in the middle of the body. Infielders and outfielders are going to do the same thing. Catchers are going to transfer in the middle of their body as well. Sometimes people think catchers take the glove and bring it up into the air, but most catchers will bring the ball somewhere towards the upper chest area, right in the middle of their body, and that's where they're going to break and transfer. So that's the first thing. The second thing is, when they take the ball out of the glove, what you're going to notice is that the fingers are going to be on top of the ball. So my fingers are on top. And that is key. Again, that might seem simple, but there's a lot of players, especially young players, that take the ball out all different ways. And if you take the ball out other than this, in my experience, it's going to lead to an arm action and an arm circle that you're not really going to want. Now, this is where it starts to get different depending on the position. So we take the ball out, fingers on top, and now we're going to see two totally different arm circles right here. So you can see Adames on the left is keeping the ball much higher, whereas Bellinger on the right is dropping the ball down below his waist. And again, think about the position and what that position requires with throwing. An outfielder is going to throw the ball much further. An infielder is going to throw it shorter and quicker. And so the arm circle reflects that. So as an infielder, one thing that we talk to our infielders about, I tell our infielders that we want to pretend that we're standing in water that is basically up to our waist. And we do not want the ball to get wet. So if that's the water, we don't want the ball to get wet. So the ball comes out of the glove, fingers are on top of the ball, and now I'm going to basically bring the ball across my chest as my arm gets back to throw. So you can see how that ball is not going to go down. Again, Bellinger is going to take the ball out, fingers on top, thumb underneath, and he's going to drop the ball down below his waist. Okay, so that's the first difference you're going to see. The second difference that you're going to see is that typically for an infielder, because they don't have to throw the ball as far, their shoulders are going to be more level. Right, you can see Adames' shoulders right here when he goes to throw are basically level. Whereas Bellinger, when he gets ready to throw, his lead shoulder is going to be a bit higher. And again, because they're throwing the ball further, they're going to put a little bit more air under the ball. You're going to see his shoulders get higher. So this is one thing, again, working with infielders. Sometimes infielders, especially young infielders, when they take the ball out, this shoulder, this lead shoulder, gets really, really high. And they'll be pretty inaccurate with their throws, and it'll take them longer to get the throw out. When in reality, again, we don't have to throw the ball as far, and so I don't need a big arm circle, and I don't need my lead shoulder to be up. And so we'll talk a lot about having the shoulders level and having the glove a little bit lower. Now here, Bellinger, even though his shoulders are slightly up, his glove is still somewhat low. You'll see sometimes outfielders will bring their glove way up here. And now the ball comes out. So let's look at the full arm circle again. And now I'll play one in regular speed. All right, so kind of a cool look at both guys. Let's look real quick on this video on the left. It kind of goes around the infield, and I want you to see how everyone is pretty similar when it comes to the infielders. So here's Adames. And now we go over here to Wendell. Right, same idea. Brings the ball to the middle. Takes it out, fingers on top, thumbs under. Shoulders are level. Glove is slightly down. Ball comes across the chest. Up and out. So really similar. So take a look at, depending on your position, take a look at your arm action, your arm circle. See, maybe it's too long, maybe it's too short. If you're a catcher, I have other videos up that talk about that, so go over and check out our catching playlist. We talk about it over there. And that's all we have. Thanks so much for watching. I appreciate it. Subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell, give it a thumbs up, all that good stuff, and we will talk to you later.
If you've enjoyed this video and want to learn more about building the elite swing, check out our new course. We have over 2 hours of content, almost 30 hitting drills. We break down the exact mechanics that you're going to want to implement into your swing. I've put the link in the description if you want to go check it out.